Okay, good morning. Today we'll learn about chapter 16, Garbage In, Garbage Out. In this chapter, we'll learn about proper management of garbage, right? And how we can control generation of a lot of garbages. Even some garbages can be converted into the compost by means of different composting methods, right? And some garbages can be recycled, they can be reused. So these are the topics that we'll actually learn, see in this chapter, right? Now we start with the garbage. As you know, we throw out so much rubbish or garbage every day from our shops, schools and homes, right? Most of the eatable materials such as pulses, biscuits, milk, oil, which we purchase from the shop, they are packed in plastic bags or even in other materials such as tins. All this wrapping material, they actually get, they go out as a garbage and they create a lot of problem. So we generate so much of garbage in our day-to-day activity. Right, we even throw coconut shell on public places, even in trains, in buses. We throw away tickets, we tear away our waste note copies. So all these material, they actually combinedly generate a lot of garbages. So it is very important for proper disposal of this garbage. Means this garbage should be properly disposed of, right? Suppose what will happen if this garbage is not removed from our homes or locality, then you will be finding a lot of problems. You will be finding a heap of garbage laying outside your house, which will create a lot of smell, bad smells. It will give shelter to lots of organisms which will create disease, right? So it is very necessary for us to deal with the garbages. So this is done in the cities by means of Safai Karmchari, who collect the garbage in trucks and take it to the low-lying open areas. That low-lying open areas is called landfill. Those landfills are filled with the garbage, and before the filling of the garbage is separated, and those materials which can be reused is separated from those material which cannot be, right? As you can see in the figure, this is the low-lying area. So garbages are being dumped in this low-lying area. Now the useful material are separated from the garbage and non-useful material are the non-useful component is separated out and it is then spread over the landfill, and then it is covered with a layer of soil. Once the landfill is completely full, it is then converted into a small park or the playground. Right. So for the next 20 or 30 years, the construction of building is not possible on that particular area because of the low compactness of the soil inside it. Right. Now we'll consider an activity to properly understand why the decomposable and non-decomposable materials are separated from the heap of garbage. So for this, we'll look at this activity, that is activity 1. In this activity, it has been said that we will make a group of two materials, right? First group will contain material which can be decomposed, that is the materials which come from our kitchen, that is the peels of the fruits, and leftover food items, leaves, etc. Those material which can easily be decomposed, right? Even egg cells, it can include egg cells, dry leaves that I have already told earlier. We can include paper bags also, right? Another group will include piece of cloth, polythene bags, broken glass, aluminium wrappers, nail, old shoes, broken toys, etc. Now these two groups will again be divided into two subgroups. Now each group will be put inside the ditch which has been dug onto the soil, right, as you can see in the figure, right? Once the items are placed into the particular ditch and it is covered with the soil, then after 3 to 4 days, when it is checked, you will be seeing that those items which are decomposable, that is which came from the kitchen, they have started rotting, right? And they are actually giving a foul smell. But those items which are not decomposable, like plastic, aluminium foil, glass, broken glass, they will remain as it is inside the soil. It means this process shows that the items which can be easily decomposed, they are good for the environment. They can be converted in the form into the compost or fertilizer, which can again be reused in as a fertilizer in the plants or different crops, right? And those items which cannot be decomposed in the soil, with the help of the soil, they can be recycled. They can be recycled to make new product, right? Even the nail can be recycled to make another item or nail. Plastic bags can be recycled to make plastic items, toys, etc. So this activity is about to find why the separation of garbages takes place, and why actually Safai Karmchari, they separate out decomposable items from non-decomposable items, right? To deal with this problem in some cities, actually, or town, municipalities, they provide separate dustbins for collecting two kinds of garbages. Usually one is blue color, one is of blue color, and another one is of green color. The dustbin with blue color is used for those materials which can be used again, such as glass, plastic, metals, and green color is for those material which can be easily decomposed. So people actually they fill the dustbin on the basis of their decomposability. So this actually makes it easier for the Safai Karmchari to separate those items while dumping in the landfill areas, right? As you can see in the figure, this figure shows burning of leaves produce, right? And these burning actually they produce a lot of harmful gases. Even burning of plastic, it generates a lot of harmful gases, which causes lots of problem. It can cause cancer also. So we should avoid ourselves from burning different materials, because when burning takes place, lots of gases are released to our atmosphere, and these gases actually they are very harmful for us and for our environment. So in place of burning decomposable items or non-decomposable items, we can separate these two items. Now we'll talk about vermicomposting. Vermicomposting is a process of conversion of decomposable items into fertilizer or compost by means of earthworm. As we already know that earthworms are called friends of the farmer because they help the farmer. They actually help in the help the farmer in plowing of the field or land, right? So in this method, earthworms are used to eat out or decompose different decomposable items, right? So to understand this topic completely, we'll understand this activity too. This activity says that let's dig a pit or keep a wooden box at a place. In this activity, we'll dig a pit or dirt ditch, or we'll keep a wooden box for this vermicomposting process. The area or the pit should not be either hot nor cold. Now, we'll spread a net or chicken mess at the bottom of the pit or the box, right? The bottom of the box or pit is covered with a chicken mess. We can also spread 1 to 2 centimeter thick layer of sand in place of mess. Now, we'll spread some vegetable waste, including peels of the fruits, over this layer of the sand. We can also use waste leaf of the trees. One can also use green leaves or dried leaves, right? Even husk particles can also be used. After this layer, we will put one layer of the material from our kitchen. After putting a layer of the material from the kitchen, we can spread a layer of the dried cow dung, which we can get from our locality. And this process is continued until we fill the entire pit or the box, right? After filling the entire pit or box, we can sprinkle some water onto it. We should make sure that water is not sprinkled on a large amount, right? A little sprinkling is enough. Now after that, we will leave the earthworm or redworm onto the top of the pit or wooden box, and they will be covered with a loose gunny bags, or even we can use old sheet of cloth, or we can use layer of the grass, because the earthworms like to eat the items, decomposable item, in dark. So we need to provide darkness to them, right? Now after this, we will continue sprinkling of water every alternative days, and this process will continue till 20 to 25 days. After 20 to 25 days, we will stop sprinkling of the water, and this fertilizer will be ready after 40 to 45 days, right? So after 40 to 45 days, we can uncover the pit to find blackish color material. That blackish color material is actually a vermicompost that can be used in our garden. It can be used in our crops, right? So this is how vermicompost are made. This is one of the few methods which we have. By using, we convert decomposable items into the compost, right? Even you can simply convert the decomposable items into compost without the earthworm. To do this, you have to just dig a pit, and you have to keep the decomposable items inside the pit, and you have to cover it with this soil or sand, right? After a few days, or maybe 30 to 40 days, you will be seeing that the items which has been kept inside the pit has been converted into the compost. So that compost can also be used as the fertilizer. That has been done because we know that the Soil contains lots of microorganisms and they help in the decomposition process, right? So that process can also be used to convert the waste materials which are decomposable into fertilizer or compost. Okay, so next time when we throw the item, we should be very careful. We should never actually contribute in the generation of a lot of garbages, right? Now next topic is plastic. It can be considered as a boon or a curse for us. Boon in a sense, plastic is, it has become a part of our daily activity. And most of the items that we use in our daily activity, they are made with plastic, right? So in that sense it is a boon for us, but it is curse because the proper disposal, the garbage created by the waste of different plastic items, by throwing different plastic items, they create a lot of problems, right? When they are burned with different materials, then they cause a lot of problem. They cause a lot of gases, which is very harmful for us. They cause very fatal disease, right? And even the disposal of plastic items is becoming very difficult, right? So in that way, it has become a curse for us. Let's discuss this topic. In this topic, we'll discuss about the use of plastic and how we can control the use of plastic, right? So as it's been given that it may be a little difficult to imagine our life without plastic, as I discussed in the beginning, because lots of the material such as toys, shoes, bags, pens, combs, toothbrushes, buckets, bottles, even water pipes, the list is very long. They are all made with the plastic items. Even some part of our bus, car, motorcycle, cycle, refrigerator, television, they are all made with the plastic, right? So the use of plastic is not a problem. The problem creates when plastics are used excessively and they are thrown out here and there, which in turn create a lot of garbages. And the disposal of garbage creates garbage that are generated from the plastic creates a lot of problem, right? So this can be controlled by proper knowledge about the proper disposal of the plastic items, right? So few things that we can do to minimize the overuse of plastic and deal with the garbage, right? First, we should try to make minimum use of plastic bags. We should use reusable bags. There are many reusable plastic bags that can be used as an alternative. We should use jute bags. We should use cotton bags, or bags made with the clothes that can be used in place of plastic, right? Also, we should insist the shopkeeper to use paper bags, because they are very cheap and they are very good for the environment. We should suggest our neighbors or the elders not to burn the plastic items, because it causes a lot of problems. It creates a lot of harmful gases. So these are the few ways through which we can control the excessive use of plastic, right? So this was the topic. This was few topics related with the chapters Garbage In, Garbage Out. Now you learn this chapter. Once you learn or read this chapter, you'll understand these topics clearly. And if you have any doubt, you can contact me. Okay. Thank you.